What do you want, gringo? What are you doing here? Have you heard? There's a war going on.
My name's John Marston. Been sent here to retrieve a couple of men. Can I speak to your commander?
You want to talk to my boss, gringo?
I guess.
Because I'm not good enough for you?
No, sir.
You think you're better than me? You come to my country, my poor little country, and you think you can be friends with the president?
No, sir. I'm sorry, sir. Things must have come out wrong. Maybe you can help me.
Okay, sorry, friend. Relax! I mean, relax!
Sure. Somewhere between a threatening stare and the soldier's arm to the teeth. Yeah. Yeah, you had me.
Welcome to Mexico, amigo! Let's come eat, drink, and then we'll talk. My name is Capitán Vicente de Santa.
John Marston.
My country is in pain, John Marston. Terrible pain. The rebels have seized the people by the throat and destroyed a way of life.
I'm no politician, sir.
And I am no soldier, a killer. But we are both beholding to our time. A brave man, perhaps you have heard of him. Coronel Allende. He's trying to preserve the order in our province. To keep our civilization alive. It is tough. The people are confused and usually swayed. Sometimes in the service of what is right, you gotta do terrible things. It breaks my heart.
I also am no moralist, sir.
I wish I enjoy your freedoms, Mr. Marston.
I'm trying to find a man, an American, an outlaw named Bill Williamson. I believe he came here to seek protection from another outlaw named Javier Escuela.
You're no moralist, but you hunt outlaws?
So it would seem. You heard anything of these men?
I am the government, or what is left of it. Outlaws seek each other. They're possibly hiding with thieves and killers who pose as freedom fighters in the hills around here. They're united under one traitor named Abraham Rrrrreyes.
Where could I find this Rrrrreyes?
If I knew, I would be there, hunting him with everything that is true within me. Rrrrreyes finds you.
Like cholera.
Something like that. But it's possible, though. My men are trying to lure him into a trap. Possibly, you could ride with us. And if everything goes okay, I'm sure the Coronel will help you.
Okay.
Vámonos! You can take your horse or ride on the wagon. We're in a hurry. You did not expect such a warm welcome from the Mexican army, I can see.
I didn't know what to expect. I hadn't even crossed the border and I was being shot at.
You will hear a lot of words like tyrant and oppression here. Words that the peasants have been taught. But do not understand meaningless words. The army is suffering a crisis of reputation.
Even I've heard about the colonel down here. He's not famous for his compassion.
This is the point. Have you met Coronel Allende? Do you know him? No. Like a papagayo? He just repeats lies, you heard.
Maybe.
Allende is a good man, a strong man. He carries the weight of a million problems on his shoulders.
Am I supposed to pity him?
You gringos are so quick to judge. You love to talk badly of other people because it makes you feel better about yourselves. Maybe you should look in the mirror.
You're the one talking about this, and I ain't here to make judgment on the way of your government. I've got enough problems with my own right now.
This isn't America, Senor Marston. We are poor. Kindness must take a different form. What is better? To pull your arm around a hungry man, or to beat him until he grows some food to eat?
I think you need to answer that question yourself.
Who are these outlaws you hunt? This Billy, the cowboy, and his Mexican friend.
Bill Williamson's a fella I used to know, and Javier Escuela? Well, I knew him too.
What do you mean? You know this man?
We was friends once. Part of the past I can't seem to get rid of.
The past is all that's real, my friend. It cannot be erased. That is the problem with the people here. They spend too much time dreaming about imaginary futures.
I know I can't change the past, but I'm sure gonna do something about the future.
Whatever helps you sleep at night, amigo. My country is full of American criminals, mostly in the service of the rebel pigs. Mexico is an easy place for a man to lose himself, whether he wants to get lost or not.
Hopefully not too easy. I ain't got much time to find these men.
There must be a high price on their heads.
The highest price.
Can I ask how much?
I'm not getting paid. It's a long story. I'm being made to do this.
I will never understand you Americans.
Me neither.
We have a system of law in Mexico, senor. And we do not tolerate people who think they can run with their own. However, if you help us, we help you. No one hides from Colonel Allende for long. This rebellion, it is a disease. It is killing this country.
Don't the people have the right to stand up for themselves?
The right? The right! Don't you throw silly ideas at me. What do you know about the rights of the Mexican people?
Very little. I'm just saying there must be something behind this rebellion.
I'll tell you what's behind there, Senor Marston. Lies. Insidious lies. The peasants are stupid, and like cows, they can be herded. It only takes a few men to move many.
Maybe they've just had enough of being called stupid.
You're talking about things you don't understand.
If you ask me something, I'm gonna give you an answer.
Are you a revolutionary? Is that why you're here?
I was once, I suppose, in a twisted kind of way. Thought I could change something if I fought hard enough.
Change what?
I don't know. Maybe that was the problem.
Revolution is always selfish. It is nothing but greed and ego. Individuals put in their own needs above those of others. It is people fighting for change when they have no idea what change is.
If you're a poor man who's been beat down all his life, any change is gonna seem good.
What? You think that overthrowing the government is going to make a poor man rich?
If you're not helping them, it's only natural they're gonna look for someone else who will.
For a tired old revolutionary, you are very naive. What do you want us to do? Walk around giving out money to every poor person in Mexico?
What a terrible idea.
First, they need to look at why they're poor. Then they need to go out and do some work rather than sitting on their culos talking about freedom.
Who's this man we're looking for? Leader of the rebels?
Rrrrreyes? He's a traitor, a liar, a coward and a sinner, a hero who has done nothing. I have far more respect for the shit I looked this morning than I ever will for that pathetic worm.
That's a nice image.
He is from a rich family, a man born in a golden cradle, who pretends to fight for the poor. He's taking advantage of the ignorant and the weak-minded.
He must be telling the people something they want to hear.
Of course he is. All that bastard does is stand in a balcón giving speeches. It's not far now. Are you ready?
Ready for what?
We will lure the rebels into a trap. There's a train leaving to Parosa soon. We're going to escort it. They will think it's a supply train. There are no supplies on it.
Very clever.
We must throw the rats out of their holes. Give them some bait they can refuse. Come on! The train is waiting. Get on your horse. You have to get to the truck. Come on, this way.
us a drink. We must escort it to Casa Madrugada.
Come on!
Who's up?